Hey guys, in this video we will make a concept map of erythropoiesis. Let's start. Erythropoiesis is process of formation of erythrocytes or red blood cells. Another similar term is hemopoiesis. It refers to process of formation of all blood cells. So we can say erythropoiesis is part of hemopoiesis. Now let's see the sites of erythropoiesis. First, intrauterine life. In early intrauterine life, RBCs are produced at mesenchyme of yolk sac. In second trimester, it's mainly produced by liver and some quantity is produced at spleen also. From third trimester, bone marrow starts producing RBCs. After birth, in childhood and later in life, they are exclusively produced from bone marrow. In childhood, they are produced from all bones, for example, membranous bones like vertebra, sternum, ribs, iliac bones, scapula and skull, and all the long bones. However, in adults, marrow in long bones undergo fat deposition and lose the capacity to produce RBCs. Exception to this are upper end of humerus and upper end of tibia, which continue to produce RBC in adults too. Now, bone marrow have pluripotent hematopoietic stem cells. These cells can give rise to any blood cells. They produce copies of themselves to keep their supply intact and also produce committed hematopoietic stem cells, which are destined to produce specific blood cells. They include lymphoid stem cells, which give rise to lymphocytes, and colony-forming units like colony-forming megakaryocytes, which produce platelets, colony-forming unit granulocyte monocyte, which give rise to granulocytes like neutrophils, eosinophils and basophils, and monocytes. Finally, the one in which we are interested today, colony-forming unit erythrocytes. It produces mature RBC after passing through several stages. These stages are proerythroblast, basophilic erythroblast, polychromatic erythroblast, orthochromatic erythroblast, reticulocyte, and finally mature RBC. The cells undergo some changes as they grow. For example, size of proerythroblast is about 20 micron in diameter. Throughout the growth, the cell decrease in size and mature RBC are of size of about 7.5 micron. Second, proerythroblast have large nucleus. However, it gets smaller and disappear at the orthochromatic erythroblast stage just before entering into the reticulocyte stage. So mature RBCs do not have nucleus. Lastly, proerythroblast have no hemoglobin. It starts appearing in polychromatic erythroblasts, and mature RBCs have hemoglobin as high as 35 grams per deciliter. It's reticulocyte that enters into the circulation and then matures to RBC. Normally their count in blood is less than 1% of total RBCs. They have reticulum of disintegrated organelles, because of which they are called reticulocytes. Now let's see the things required for erythropoiesis. First, erythropoietin. It is secreted from fibroblast-like cells located around renal tubule in kidney. Stimulus for erythropoietin release is mainly hypoxia. Other minor stimuli are norepinephrine, androgens, thyroid hormones, etc. It promotes production of proerythroblast from stem cells and also speeds up the growth of the cells through different stages. Thus, under influence of erythropoietin, more RBCs are produced. Other factors include interleukin-3, folic acid and vitamin B12 for DNA synthesis, and iron for hemoglobin. That's it friends for this video. If you learned something new from this video, please share it with your friends too. And don't forget to subscribe, because lots more to come. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.